thedailymass.com. Experience the Roman Catholic Mass from historic St. Louis Cathedral every day on thedailymass.com. His love, anywhere in the world.
I'm Sarah McDonald.
I'm Jason Angelette. Welcome back to Issues in Faith.
Well, it's nice to be back after our summer break.
Yes.
We had a great summer. I hope you all were able to enjoy.
It was great. We got to do a little family vacation, a lot of fun events for faith and marriage that we were able to accomplish, praise God, over the summer. And here we are coming right back to a beautiful fall.
That's right. And we have so much going on this fall. We're obviously going to be announcing the results, the recommendations, what we're going to be implementing for the Catholic School Strategic Plan.
Looking forward to that. I mean, we spent a lot of time going over that because there was just so much that was involved in that process. So I'm looking forward to hear about the fruits.
Oh, yeah. It's going to be very interesting. And there's a meeting in September for priests and principals to kind of review the recommendations for Archbishop Amon to get that feedback. And then shortly after that, we'll have the final recommendation. So that'll be very important. We have the things that happen every year with Pro-Life Awareness Month in October, just tons of activities coming up. And then all of this, everything we're working on right now, is going to kind of culminate with the start of the Year of the Family that Archbishop Benjamin has asked for in January.
So very excited about that.
Very exciting. And speaking of families, we are actually currently within the National Natural Family Planning Week.
That's right.
So this is a really important week. We're using social media at the Archdiocese a lot to help promote not only awareness of NFP, but why NFP, why the church teaches NFP.
And that is so important.
Testimonials, it is.
So important to hear all the testimonies, hear important the research, because so many people are so misinformed. Even doctors, OBGYNs, are so misinformed, and they think it's the old rhythm method where it's got this low percentage of success, which actually is not that low as if people have done the research on that. But the current natural family planning is very successful. It's very healthy. It's very go green. I mean, there's
it's
so much
organic family.
It's organic family planning. I mean, there's so much about it that is such a blessing. But not only for health, but also spiritual health and the relationship to spouses and the respect that it gives to the couple. I mean, it is absolutely amazing. I mean, even to the divorce rate, the couples who practice natural family planning have a divorce rate of less than 2%. I mean, that's if that's not confidence and insurance for your marriage, then I don't know what is.
Right, and it's so true that when people look at couples or say, oh, you're doing natural family planning, you're going to end up with tons of kids. Well, you're going to have children. That's what God's planned for you. But you are making choices about your family and your relationship together. And I think that's what's so important is you're making the choices together as a couple.
That's right.
And the woman's not having more say or the man's not having more say. The husband and wife are coming together
before God.
That's right.
And that's the whole blessing, I think, why it's so grace-filled and why couples are so strong is because it has to be a dialogue with God. And so they remain in constant relationship, constant dialogue, but also constant graces because they've allowed themselves to be open to God's love and open to God's graces and not block that grace from God.
Very good. Well, I'm so grateful that, you know, we were introduced to the teaching.
Yeah, praise God. We too.
We were an engaged couple and, you know, for the work that Wilwood's marriage, Faith Marriage, does to continue couples. It's so easy for people to think it's something that engaged couples do, but it's an entire life journey.
Yeah, amen. Yes, indeed.
Popular Catholic author and apologist Matthew Kelly will be in town this month giving a special presentation for area Catholics. And tonight we have him on the phone to talk about his ministry and what people can expect from the upcoming event. Thank you so much for being with us, Matthew.
You're very welcome. Great to be with you.
Well, first I want to ask you to please tell us about yourself and how you got started in this ministry.
You know, it happened. I grew up in Australia. I was in business school. And in my first year of business school, they used to have an event in Sydney where a business leader would speak and a first-year business student would speak. And I got invited to speak at that, and you got 20 minutes to give your view on faith and business. And that was the first time I spoke, and people heard me speak at that, and they invited me to speak at something else. And then people heard me speak at that, invited me to speak at something else. So it began quite organically, and then out of that emerged the writing. People would say, well, you should write some of this stuff down. And so that's how it happened 20 years ago now, next year.
Well, and it is. That's certainly when you can see God's will in your life. When you are just volunteering or asked to do something that seems sort of small and insignificant, and it just blossoms. And that's when you really know God and the Holy Spirit are working.
Exactly.
Well, Dynamic Catholic is a powerful title to give to your ministry. Do you have any, is there a meaning behind the name? And what does that dynamic mean for people who are working with you?
I guess the work my team and I are trying to do is revitalize Catholicism in America, revitalize the spirituality of individual Catholics and of their parishes. And, you know, we just feel like, you know, if there were more dynamic Catholics in parishes, Catholics would be more dynamic, and if the church was more dynamic, it would be more attractive to the underchurched and the unchurched that we're trying to attract to, you know, an intimate relationship with God. And so I don't think you bump into people who say, oh, the church doesn't need any more dynamic Catholics. I think it's fairly obvious to people, hey, yeah, we need more dynamic Catholics. And that's essentially how we came up with sort of the name for the Dynamic Catholic Institute, and of course, sort of our face of the world, which is dynamiccatholic.com.
And I think that's so important what you mentioned, and Archbishop Amen is really, really keen on strengthening the parish family and the parish life. And so what are some things that you do, or how can you recommend, you know, getting those dynamic Catholics involved in their parishes?
Yeah, it's interesting, you know, because the parish really is the heartbeat of the church. You know, we've seen people try and do things outside of parish life within the church, and most of the time they die because the parish system, the parish model, the parish itself tends to breathe life into, you know, all sorts of things and create structure and opportunity for people to grow in their faith. We've done some fascinating research in the last 3 or 4 years that's examined the difference between highly engaged Catholics and disengaged Catholics. Mm-hmm. And one of the things that we've noticed in this research, which we're actually going to publish in September, so it hasn't been published yet,
okay,
but one of the things we've noticed in the research that highly engaged Catholics, they have a moment in their life where they have a conversion experience of some sort. Now, some people, it happens when they pick up a book or a CD. Some people go to a retreat. Some people, you know, they have a friend sort of take them deeper into the faith,
sure,
or explain something to them about the faith. But it's interesting that the highly engaged in different areas tend to have similar things that trigger it, you know. So I was in a parish last week, and I said to the pastor, I said, you know, if you look at the highly engaged parishioners in your church, what's been the trigger for them? And he said, oh, it's Christ Renews His Parish. You know, which, mm-hmm, is, for those that don't know, it's sort of like a weekend retreat type experience.
Okay.
And he said, you know, when I look at the 50 people who do everything in my parish, 45 of them have been through Christ Renews His Parish. You know, and I said to him, well, what does that tell us? That tells us that that works in your parish. Now, that might not work in every parish, but we know that that's working in your parish. And so really what the what that parish should do is they should come out with a big mandate, a big bold vision, and say, we want everyone in our parish to go through Christ Renews His Parish in the next 3 years.
That would be powerful. That would be powerful for any parish to do.
Exactly, you know, but what's happening is we're hypnotized by complexity. There's so much to Catholicism. It's so rich, so deep, so, mm-hmm, broad. People don't know where to start. We have to give people a starting point.
I think that's a wonderful point. And you will be in our area hosting Living Each Day with Passion and Purpose on August 18th. Who would you recommend this day to, and what can people expect?
Probably anyone between the age of 12 or 13 and 105. the whole idea of sort of living every day with passion and purpose is I think something that is universally attractive to us. We want to live with more passion. We want to live with more purpose. How do we get there, I think, is the challenge. And, you know, we start the day by talking about how do we listen to the voice of God in our lives, because people who live with passion and purpose have more clarity in their life. They have a clearer sense of who they are and what they're here for. They have a clearer sense of what's important to them and what matters most in their lives. And because they have a clearer sense of all this, they're able to say no. And one of the things that modern people really struggle with is saying no to things.
Mm-hmm.
And so the only way that you become really good at saying no is by being really clear about what's most important to you and what matters most to you and what you're here for and what God's saying to you in your life. And so we start the day by talking about, how do we learn to listen to the voice of God in our lives? And how do we know when we're hearing God's voice in our life, or, you know, we're just hearing a voice in our head, or just hearing our own thoughts, or that sort of thing? And it's sort of a really powerful session in the morning. And then there's four sessions, and we go into sort of the different areas of life, you know, whether it's work or money or relationships or health and well-being, to help people discover, okay, what's helping them live with passion and purpose? What are the obstacles to them living with passion and purpose? And it's going to be a great day. We do this once a month in a different city across the country.
Okay.
We've been doing it for about 2 years. It's been really powerful. I bring a fabulous musician with me, Elliot Morris, mm-hmm. Just a really talented guy, and he and I do the day together. I think it's about 9 to 1:30, mm-hmm. and I'm looking forward to coming down there.
Well, very good. Well, we are very much looking forward to having you here in our area. I want to thank you. It's clear just from our very brief conversation and other things that I've read from you that you do live your day with passion and purpose, and we are very grateful for you and for the work and the ministry that you do through the grace of God. So thank you so much for being with us tonight, Matthew. We hope to be able to talk with you again sometime soon.
I appreciate it. Thanks for the great work you're doing.
Well, thank you. Well, once again, Matthew will be leading the retreat, Leaving Each Day with Passion and Purpose, on August 18th at St. Joseph Abbey. For more information, you can go online to www.dynamiccatholic.com, or locally you can call Kathy at 985-373-4533. And we'll be back with more Issues in Faith right after the break.
What will the world ask of them? Whatever it is, they'll be prepared to answer. Because in a safe and disciplined environment, Louisiana Catholic schools shape tomorrow's leaders. Catholic students are rising. 99% graduate. Almost all go to college. They'll earn higher wages, be community involved, more tolerant of diverse views. And the world will be better because of them. Louisiana Catholic schools, in a class of their own.
Heart of Woman's New Life Center is its outreach to women in unplanned pregnancies, especially those who are seeking an abortion. Our professional counseling services, combined with free ultrasound tests, provide each woman with the nurturing she needs while also revealing her unborn child to her. For more information about the life-saving work of Woman's New Life Center, call 504-831-3117 or visit womansnewlife.com.
For some, their Catholic school or CCD religion classes they take as children is the end of their Catholic education. For others, it's a lifelong journey. And here to talk to us about the local Catholic Church is offering in the area of faith formation for adults is Mrs. Alice Hughes, the Director of the Office of Religious Education here in New Orleans. Mrs. Hughes, thanks so much for being with us again.
Thank you.
Good
Jason.
Seeing you. So tell us, what is the mission of the Office of Religious Education?
The mission in the end, the ORE office, is the same as a mission throughout the Archdiocese, mm-hmm. and it's that we are impelled by Christ's call, because all of us are called through our baptism,
Amen.
That we are here to serve. All of our departments and offices are here to serve in collaboration with the Archbishop and with each other in bringing about the reign of God. We're guided by the Holy Spirit, and we work in service to and in collaboration with our parishes, our schools, and other organizations. And we work with them to evangelize and to catechize. And those two key words, evangelize and catechize. We offer witness, service. We help lead worship. Mm-hmm. We help in the pastoral care of all God's people, and mainly to advance the saving mission of Jesus.
Well, praise God. Well, there's some upcoming classes, and tell us a little bit about
that. We're just finishing next week what I call our summer blitz. Uh-huh. We had 19 sites all throughout the Archdiocese, going all the way from Luling all the way up to Franklinton, East Shore, West Shore, North, South, any direction we had it. We had over 400 participants in 6 weeks. I'm very, very pleased. That was between Catholic school religion teachers and parish catechists and adults just wanting to enrich their faith. That was just the beginning with our new program. In the fall, we also are going to have some classes being offered. We have some definite ones that are on our website right now. Mm-hmm. And would you like the website address?
Yeah, what's the website?
Our website is www.oreArchdio-no.com.
Okay.
And there's a link that is to the schedule for courses. You click on that link, you see everything that we have offered, and you're able to register for our courses. We're also telling parishes and school faculties that if they would like us to bring a course to them, we'd be more than happy. We have five of us in our office, myself plus four associates that are willing and able to come. My philosophy is we work for you, and so use us.
You
pay our salary, so use the gifts that God has given us.
Yeah.
And we also have some other tremendous facilitators throughout the Archdiocese that we use this summer and that we have at your beck and call during the year. Father David Sin over at St. Anthony's on Canal Street will be offering some courses. Hopefully Father Philip from St. Dominic's will. Mm-hmm. And those are just two that have contacted us for wanting courses. Father David's are up online now, and we're waiting to hear from everybody else for what they want.
You know, the faith is so rich. I mean, I was so late coming to understand the faith, and I'm still growing as we all are, right?
Yes.
But to take that invitation to go into the faith, to learn about it, to learn the history, the richness, the beauty, the whys behind the whats. Who are you, marketing or targeting as your audience eligible to come to these classes?
In one sense, the main target area are certainly our Catholic school religion teachers and our catechists and directors of our parish catechetical leaders in our parishes. Those are the people that we require that they get certified through the archdiocesan certification courses. However, my deep, deep love in the church and 39 years as a religious educator are for the adults for faith formation.
Praise God.
And we're offering these courses not just for certification, but hopefully for people's enrichment and formational needs. My goal is that people are not just going to come in to check off boxes that
I've got to do
now,
this, yeah.
But my main goal is that they fall deeper in love with God.
Yes.
Once you know about God, how can you not want to keep learning about God and fall deeper in love with
God? Amen.
I think to me one of the richest statements that the Archbishop made was when he allowed me to hire an associate director for adult faith formation.
Yeah.
That just to me speaks volumes. Mm-hmm. We're tremendous with children.
Yeah.
We do all of our sacramental prep up to confirmation, and somehow we've instilled that's it, that you know everything there is to know about God, and there's so much more to learn.
Amen.
So one of our goals this year is to strengthen adult faith formation within parishes. Mr. Vincent Scazzari is our associate, and Vincent will be going out. If a parish does not have a faith formation committee, he will help establish an adult faith formation committee. We are a resource for parishes and for schools. We have parents and faculty members in schools that we want to hit. It goes with so many things that are going on this year. This is the year, the Pope says this is year of faith.
Mm-hmm.
Our diocese will have the year of the family.
I'm excited about that.
New evangelization.
That's right.
You put all of those together. Families are where faith and evangelization comes.
That's right.
And if the parents don't see that, it's also important for them.
Yes.
It's wonderful that we say, bring your children, but they're the prime educators and they need to be educated.
The saying, do as I say, not as I do, does not get the faith passed on.
No.
And it doesn't encourage anybody to fall in love with Christ. We need witnesses.
Absolutely. That's what the new evangelization is all about. Witness and to live.
We're running, getting close out of time, but there's a big event coming up September 16th, Catechetical Sunday. There's the Hafir Conference coming up in January. Tell us a little about some of those.
The Catechetical Sunday theme, Catechetical Sunday is celebrated on the third Sunday of September, September 16th this year. The theme this year is Catechists and Teachers as Agents of New Evangelization. Again, evangelization, faith, year of the family. To carry out that theme of faith in the family, then we progress throughout the year, and then our regional religious education conference of Hofinger Conference. This year it's going to be January the 3rd, 4th, and 5th, and once again the Pontchartrain Center. I think everybody's pleased with that, with the parking situation.
Oh, yeah,
free
sure.
parking
yeah.
and a lot of parking.
A lot of space.
This year our theme is Catch the Faith and Pass It On. And we're hoping that a lot of people will come to Catch the Faith and Pass It On. We're having a Thursday night event this year, so people can come register on Thursday night. The different publishers that are there are going to showcase different items that they have that are new for this year, especially highlighting families and faith. And if anyone would like to register, they can go to our website, and there's a link to the Hofinger Conference also.
Mrs. Hughes, thank you so much. You are so busy with all your stuff that you're doing, but the church is being blessed because of it. So thank you so much for all that you're doing.
Thank you, Jason.
Again, you can find the complete schedule of classes offered by the ORE office online at www.ore.arch-no.org. You can also call 504-861-6270 for more information. And when we come back, a special celebration for a special lady at St. Michael's Special School. This is Issues in Faith on LAE.
The grief and loss resulting from an abortion can be overwhelming. Many women and men need a safe place to heal. The Woman's New Life Center is that place. We treat each woman and man with the utmost respect and dignity. We offer individual counseling and referrals to post-abortion retreats that offer a psychological and spiritual approach to healing. Call 504-831-3117 or visit womansnewlife.com.
We never forget our best teachers, the ones who do so much more than teach. They inspire and insist we bring our best in everything we do. We find those mentors in our Catholic schools. It's why Catholic school graduates consistently go on to college, land better jobs, embrace faith, and lead. Louisiana Catholic Schools, in a class of their own.
This summer, St. Michael's Special School said a sweet goodbye to a favorite friend and principal. Ms. Jane Silva is retiring after 37 years at the school. All the kids turned out to show her just how much they love her, and Janet Gross has the story.
Jane Silva is one of the school's biggest cheerleaders, encouraging and participating and celebrating all that is St. Michael's. But on this day, everyone's cheering her on as well. She would love to stay, but her health has forced her to step down. This mass and special celebration is in her honor.
You have been a teacher. You have been a principal. You have been an administrator. You have been a friend. You have been Jesus. And we thank you for your big heart and for your long arms that embrace so many people.
Now other arms reach out to her, showing appreciation.
They bring to the table nothing but love and nothing but complete trust in who is helping them. They've never met a stranger. So when people say, how can you work so long in one place? We say, how can you not? Where else would you want to go that every day you come in, somebody thinks you're the greatest ever? What a reward.
She came to the school shortly after college. Her aunt, Sister Lillian, the school's founder, wanted her to be a part of it. Now, it's a big part of her.
Each child is such a separate need, and each child needs your individual attention. And it's our place to help find them, find themselves, and more importantly, find their God, and find their faith, and find their holiness.
They love her here and are not shy to say it on stage or off.
Miss Jane is wonderful. We love her so much. She has done many great things for us.
Miss Jane is our guardian angel.
She takes care of our blue roses.
Blue roses, that's what they call the students here. Precious flowers given time and space to bloom.
She has the power of a smile, the power of a hug, or just the power of her name. If a child is being bad, you just say, well, we'll just have to get Miss Jane. And I'm telling you, it's like magic.
She's not only my principal and like my boss, but she's a friend, and she's a friend first. You know, so that, you know, she's, we'll still see her.
I see skies of blue and clouds.
And reassuring the students that any tears were tears of joy and celebration, she echoed the words of Lou Gehrig as she said goodbye.
But the words were beautiful when he said, today he felt like the luckiest man in the world. Well, today I know that I am the luckiest principal in the world. So I thank you for all your efforts.
And though the adults shared some tears, the students shared the joy and love they feel for their principal with a song and a show for Miss Jane. I'm Janet Gross for Issues and Faith.
And while Miss Jane won't be there every day to watch over her blue roses, the Archbishop has given her the title of Principal Emeritus, so she is always welcome to come back.
If you have a question for us or an idea that you'd like to see on air, please write to us at Issues in Faith, 3330 North Causeway Boulevard, Suite 345, Metairie, Louisiana, 7002. Or you can email us at questions@wlae.com. Plus, if you missed an episode, you can catch up online at www.archdiocese-no.org.
And that's our program for this evening. For all of us at Issues in Faith, thanks for watching.
We'll be back next week. Hope you join us again soon. Until then, God bless.